From Yahoo News, passenger drone that can fly at 80 miles an hour is exhibited in China. A drone big enough to carry human passengers was exhibited in China this week, and manufacturer Yang hoped that the machine could soon work like a flying taxi. The Yang 216 has a top speed of 80 miles an hour and is autonomous, receiving signals via a 4G or 5G phone network from a command and control center. It can carry a payload of up to 220 kilograms and has a range of up to 20 miles. The aircraft is fully electric powered and can be charged off the mains in 1 hour. It requires no runway to take off. Yihang said, quote, the technology of autonomous flight eliminates the possibility of failure or malfunction caused by man-made errors. Without any concern about controlling or operating the aircraft, the passenger can just sit and enjoy the journey. We might not ever get self-driving cars as the dominant transportation paradigm. We might skip straight ahead to self-flying cars. Something I've been predicting for years now. This is a technology that really is way behind in terms of our potential to have done this years ago. This should be the norm. Not only is this amazing for so many things, because this is going to be one way or another, something like this, just because we know that this is possible, this is going to be the new transportation paradigm. This is going to be how people get around from now on. Maybe not, okay, not now, but soon, from soon on, this is going to be the general reality. This is going to be cheaper than a car, more efficient than a car, lower maintenance than a car, more effective than a car, and I would bet you safer than a car. And they can design these pods to be, you know, airbag sensor crash proof. So, like, they could probably design this thing to be able to crash. I mean, they're not going to. You're going to have so many good sensors on these. Like, but then if it fell out of the sky, I mean, it's going to be flying at a low enough altitude, I mean, over the tree line, zipping around, not constrained by roads, up to 80 miles an hour already with just this model, 20-mile range. Not that impressive. That seems like the limiting factor at this point. But if you can get around from stop to, if you go 20 miles, I mean, how many of your, if you go 20 miles to the groceries, like how most of human travel, even commuting, is in trips shorter than 20 miles. Eventually, you're going to be able to park these things in little charging docks. Piece of cake, 20 miles. You're going to be able to get around, do everything. And they're going to be safer than a car by far. I mean, you fall out of the sky. Like, if it's going 80 miles an hour, I mean, I bet it's even going to have a backup system. Like, you hit a wall, you hit a cliff or a building. I mean, but it's going to have a sensor that's going to make that impossible. That if it sees a wall coming, it's just going to drop. It's going to, you know, parachute and, you know, drop out of the sky. And these things are going to be so rare because they're so much more reliable and effective than cars, so much more safer with the navigation. And you know what this means? You know, this really is a, at least in the United States and really globally, even a bigger problem. But even in the United States where we think of, you know, we have the government making our roads for us, and making sure that our cars are safe with all their legislation and regulation of the automobile industry, 40,000 Americans die on American roads every single year, and most of them needlessly, because we have the technology for a safer transportation paradigm. This is it. Welcome to the future, right around the corner.